Hello everyone, my name is Hans Lux, and I'm here today with a new series I'm calling Licks from the Source. The source being the great master improvisers. And every week I'm going to bring you a new lick from a great musician, break it down a little bit, show you the original context, and maybe more importantly, show you some other applications and how you might use it in your own playing. For volume one today, we're going to start with the great trumpeter Freddie Hubbard. This is a little lick he plays on Dolphin Dance by the great Herbie Hancock. And it starts in measure four. It's a quick 2-5-1 to G major. So it's two beats of A minor 7, two beats of D7, resolving into G major. It's a nice little double time lick. And let's start off by playing the recording. So I'm going to play it back from a few measures so you can kind of hear the context of it. And we'll take it from there. So that was the one, that one right there, you know. So that starts like on the end of two, and it's just a quick. Slow it down. Okay. Nice little idea there. And so that's the original context, but what other ways could we use this lick? Well, the first thing that came to mind is it's kind of a hard double time lick. It's not super easy to play. I mean, it's not the hardest thing, but it's. So the first thing we can do is we can make it easier by making it a long 2-5-1 lick. So instead of, we could do 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4. So if we did it like that, it would start on the and of 3. 1-2-3. Okay, so that's maybe the simplest way we can change the lick is just. Of course, we can change the key, so maybe let's go to, say, E-flat, 2-3. Okay. And we could play it through all 12, and especially in guitar, you might want to play it in at least two different positions. So originally, I played the lick here, starting on the high E string on the 5th fret. But I kind of like the sound of it better here, starting on the B string. But those are the two positions that I would play that lick in that octave. Now, another thing we could do is we could take the lick, and let's maybe try to alter it slightly or change it slightly to fit it over a different harmony. Maybe, like, let's say, originally the lick is A minor, D7 to G major. What if we tried to fit it over an A7, or let's say an A13 flat 9 sound? Like this. So, that kind of sound. So those notes all fit so far. And maybe we change the D to a D sharp. Okay. And then maybe we resolve it to a D minor. Something like that. So now all of a sudden, that was over a C13 flat 9, so we could move it to different keys there. Another way we could simply play this lick is just over a static minor chord. Originally it resolves to G major. We could just play the exact same lick as Freddie played it, but just play it over a static G minor chord. Or G minor 6 here. I'm just thinking you
could almost play that as a minor 2-5-1 lick as well, but it would work great just as a static G minor lick, you know, or here we go. That's C minor 6. Okay? So those are three or four different ways you could play that lick. You could play it in the original context as a double time lick. You could play it in a longer 2-5-1 form. I played it as a 13-flat-9 sound, and you could just play it over that, like a static dominant chord, or you could also resolve it to a minor chord, and you could play it over a static minor chord. So just that one little piece of information that Freddie gave us can be stretched into so many different ways. So I'll have the link below in the description with a PDF. So if you'd like to look at it in the PDF form, I'll have that available. But yeah, that's it for today. The great Freddie Hubbard on Dolphin Dance. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you back next week for Volume 2. Thanks so much.